In this video lecture, we will look at the points related to isolation of phyllosphere microflora. First, we will try to find out what is the meaning for phyllosphere. So, phyllosphere is a common term used there in microbiology, which refers to the total above ground surface of a plant, which is viewed as a habitat for the microorganism. So, phyllosphere is the one which is surrounding the leaf surface. So, what is the function there happening there in the phyllosphere? Phyllosphere is an ecologically and economically important ecosystem wherein diverse microbial communities could be present. So, microbes there present in the phyllosphere play a critical role in the protecting plants against various other disease-causing organisms. Apart from that, they will be promoting the plant growth by various kind of plant growth promoting activities such as fixing of nitrogen there in the leaf surface, production of more exopolysaccharides so that the other bacteria can easily adhere to that particular place and multiply. Like that, different functions can be carried out by the phyllosphere microorganisms. Now we come into one of the phyllosphere important microorganism that is referred as a pink pigmented facultative methylotrophs. So, they are the organism which are present in diverse environment, whereas they found more numbers there in the phyllosphere. The common pink pigmented facultative methylotrophs belonging to the genus Methylobacterium, and they are all known to metabolize methanol. They belong to phylum Proteobacteria, class alpha Proteobacteria and order Rhizobiales within the family Methylobacteriaceae. As I already told, they are referred as a pink pigmented facultative methylotrophs. They are actually hemoorganotrophs and facultative methylotrophic in nature. They are gram-negative, strictly aerobic type of metabolism in which oxygen is serving as a terminal electron acceptor, which indirectly says that they are all catalase as well as oxidase positive culture. They form red to pink color colonies in the agar surface, especially when they are grown on a methanol mineral salts media or ammonium mineral salts media. They produced pink to red coloration colony. This pink color is resulted due to the production of huge amount of carotenoids in these cultures. These carotenoids plays a role in protection of this bacteria against the harsh effects of the sunlight. They are all mesophilic in nature. They can able to use formate, methanol, formaldehyde, and even methylated amines as their carbon sources. They have a ubiquitous distribution, that is, they can able to find in soil, dust, lake sediments, leaf surface, plant endophyte, nodule. They are airborne also, that is, they can be commonly present there in the air. So, air sampling could easily result in identification of a Methylobacterium. Next, we look at the points related to Methylobacteria in association with the plant system. Currently, around some 48 species of Methylobacterium seems to be existing there. So, you can look at here the various species of the Methylobacterium. In the list that is showing a black shading refers to those organisms that are having a plant association. So, more number of Methylobacteriums have been commonly present there in the plant system. That is the reason why we have taken isolation of a Methylobacterium from the phyllosphere microflora. So, almost every plant in the earth found to harbor at least one species of a Methylobacterium. And apart from plant system, they are all commonly present there in the freshwater habitats also. So, this Methylobacteria, which are also referred as a pink pigmented facultative methylotrophs, may be present as a more than 70% of the phyllosphere flora of the plant system. They are symbiotically coexisting with the plant mainly by using the plant metabolite methanol. That is, they use methanol as their carbon substrate and grow there in the plant system. We will see later how methanol is obtained there in the plants. Okay. It is known that atmospheric methanol produced by plants constitutes about 40 to 46% of the total volatile atmospheric organic carbon that have been present there. So, methanol in the plants is obtained mainly through two processes. One is during the demethylation of the cell wall pectin. Another is due to functioning of a pathway called as a tetrahydrofolate pathway, in which protein methyl transferase enzyme helps in the degradation of lignin that have been present in the secondary cell wall. that in turn releases the methanol there in the atmosphere. Now we look at how the methanol is released there from the plant system. Methanol is commonly present there in the pectin. So you all know pectin is one of the important organic matter constituent. Pectin is a heterogeneous class of polymer which represents up to 20 to 30% of the dry mass weight in the dicot plants. Within the wall space, they have been de-esterified by a group of cell wall associated enzyme called as a pectin methyl esterases. That is, during the growth of the plants, the old cell wall will be replaced there with the new one. At that juncture, this kind of a pectin methyl esterases enzyme will act on the methyl ester containing polymers. Actually, this function of this pectin methyl esterases is to convert the galactouronan methyl ester form into galactouronan demethylated form. So that is the one shown there in the image. During this process, a lot of methanol will be released. This methanol will be reaching there into the atmosphere, or this methanol that have been coming out from the leaf surface are utilized by the methylobacteria. Next, we look at the media used for isolation of this methylobacteria. Two different media are commonly used. One is methanol mineral salts media. So this is the composition of this medium. Here methanol is the carbon source. The methanol can be added at a 0.1 to 0.2% after completion of sterilization of all other constituents of the media. One more media used for isolation of this organism is ammonium mineral salts medium. In this medium, two important constituents are playing a major role. One is methanol, which is added after sterilization of all other constituents of the media at a 400 microliter per 100 ml of the media. And then another important constituent need to be added is the cyclohexamide, which is added at 100 microgram per ml of the medium. Cyclohexamide is added mainly to prevent the growth of the fungi that usually found associated there with the methylobacterium, and they are also found living with the methylobacterium in the leaf surface. So this cyclohexamide will selectively kill the fungi, whereas it will allow the growth of the bacteria. Here the media composition is prepared in such a way you need to prepare in lots. Say for example, for dipotassium hydrogen phosphate, separately you have to prepare a stocks of 100 ml. So as most of the constituents of this media are very trace in quantity, you need to prepare a stock as shown here. From the stock, some volume of material is taken or aliquoted, and from there you need to prepare the actual media. So that is a point again very important with reference to the methylobacteria's media preparation. So you need to prepare the media in such way, and then the media need to be poured there into the petri plate as usual. Before pouring, two things are important. One is addition of methanol, and next one is addition of cyclohexamide. Then the plates are need to be solidified and incubated for 24 hours, mainly to find out any other contamination is arising there on the prepared plates. And then in the subsequent day, the culture may be isolated by leaf imprinting technique. So here you can able to see some of the images there of the leaf imprinting technique. That is, you will be keeping the leaf there on the surface of the plate. After keeping the leaf for some 10 to 15 minutes, that is by pressing over the surface of the agar, you need to take the leaf out and you can discard the leaf. Then the plates need to be kept for incubation at a room temperature. After a 3 or 4 days incubation, you can able to see the growth of the methylobacterium. Now we will try to see some of the efforts that have been taken by your previous batch students to isolate the methylobacterium. The first batch to isolate the methylobacterium was in 2015. They have isolated the methylobacterium from Ficus religiosa plant. Tamil la vandu arasa maram solluvanga. Indha arasa maram vandu oru namba department odaya just oru wall la otti irundhathu. Adodaya leaves collect panni andha leaf vandu impregnate panni, that is imprint panni, they have isolated the methylobacterium. Indha methylobacterium vandu is something similar to a methylobacterium isolated from a dry and a arid soil. அப்படி அவங்க ஐசோலேட் பண்ண மெத்தலோபாக்டீரியத்தை நம்ம எப்படி மெத்தலோபாக்டீரியம்னு we have find out means it's by a 6-ness rRNA sequencing. So by that they have identified that organism as a methylobacterium taraniae. So this is the work that was conducted in the year 2014 batch of students. So their names have been provided here and the submission details of our college was also available here. Again, the 2017 batch of the student have isolated the Methylobacterium. So they have collected the leaf samples and the leaf samples have been imprinted there in a methanol or ammonium mineral salts media. Rendu media alume they have did it using the leaf imprinting technique. So this leaf imprinting technique was first performed by Holland, mainly to identify certain common bacteria present there in the leaf surface. Here you can able to see the leaf imprinted plate. And the plate la leaf imprint panitu, they have incubated for 5 to 6 days or even sometimes 7 days it will go. After that, if you see the plates, the plate will show a growth of Methylobacterium there, which is identified easily by their coloration, that is a pink to reddish coloration due to the presence of the carotenoids. So this is the organism they have identified, and this organism was subcultured and further taken for a 6S rRNA sequencing. Then by constructing a phylogenetic tree, they have identified it belong to a Methylobacterium species. Again, this Methylobacterium was taken for a 6S rRNA sequencing, mainly to identify what is the species of the Methylobacterium. So this is the outcome of the 6S rRNA sequencing. And it was identified as a Methylobacterium rhodesianum. So this has been submitted there in the GenBank. So this is a GenBank entry of the culture what we have isolated. And the students belonging to those batch has been given here. And the year of submission is around 2017. Next, we look at the benefits of the Methylobacterium to the plant species. What are all the beneficial things it can able to do for the plants? So they play a major role in cytokinin production. Thus, it regulates the physiological process in the plants like stimulation of cell division there in the plant cells. In addition to cytokinin, it also produces other phytohormones such as indole acetic acid and even vitamin B12. Methylobacterium producing certain specific enzyme like urease play a major role there in the nitrogen metabolism in germinating seedlings, especially in the soybean seed germination, that is making the reserved nitrogen available with the help of a urease enzyme is effected by Methylobacterium. They produce lot of exopolysaccharide that helps in bacterial colony adherence there to the leaf surface. They produce a growth modulating enzyme called as a ACCDMase, which can enhance the plant growth and even enhance the tolerance of plants to various metal related stresses. That is, this enzyme plays a major role in modulating the amount of stress ethylene associated there in the plant system. Methylobacterium have been studied for degradation of lot of toxic xenobiotic compounds that includes the halomethane, methyl acetate, ethyl acetate, acetone and toluene. So these are the things that may be come across easily through certain pesticide addition into the leaf surface. So in nature, they have evolved the mechanism to degrade such kind of a xenobiotic compounds there.